And now, can I call upon the sixth speaker, last but not least, Lee Hansen, with his speech title, Not Good Enough. Not Good Enough, Lee Hansen.
We were all placed in our groups for this assignment project. Although just a borderline student, I was placed in a group of top students. As I went through the assignment and read, I approached the group wanting to share my ideas, thoughts, and views. I approached them really enthusiastically, only to meet their glare of disapproval. They told me, "Hansen, do you think I can contribute anything here? You are mentally slow, unsociable, and always dreaming. Why don't you sit in a corner and wait till we finish?" It was like entering a room full of confidence, only to have a bucket of ice cold water splashing into you. I was drenched from head to toe. I felt useless. I felt unwanted. I felt just not good enough. Contest chair, fellow Toastmasters, friends, remember the last time someone told you that you were not good enough? That you were useless? That you were not handsome enough? Not clever enough? Not strong enough? And being you is just not enough? That was exactly how I felt. To make things worse, the teacher spotted me sitting in a corner, walked over and started talking to me sternly. "Hansen, why are you sitting in a corner and not helping in the group work?" Before I could give my justification and my part of the story, he put his hand up and shook his head. "No excuses, boy. I always thought you lacked imagination and had no original ideas. If you continue like this, you would fail your exams, you would not be able to graduate, and you will definitely not succeed in life." At that moment, my hopes, dreams, and desires all were shattered. Another bucket of ice cold water drenched me from head to toe. The final bell rang, signaling the end of classes. Feeling down, I packed my books and began to make my way out of class. On my way out, I knocked into another student. We all dropped our belongings. We quickly apologized and helped each other out. As I was in a rush, I quickly grabbed my things, apologized to him again, and rushed out to the already waiting school bus. I was the last man on the bus. For some apparent reason, the bus driver was in a foul mood and decided to give me a piece of his mind. "Why are you late, boy? You know I had to fetch afternoon class also. Because of you, I'm now late. Because of you, they'll all now be late. You should have been cut from this trip home, boy." Another bucket of ice cold water drenched me from head to toe. So drenched, soaked, cold, that I feel chills running up my spine. Finally, I reached home, pulled the chair out, again to reflect. Am I really useless? Am I really hopeless? Is being me just not good enough? Student in the collision, I must have accidentally put it back, took it back. I checked out its contents. Surprisingly, the book was a very motivational book. It told stories of successful people and the difficulties they took in reaching them. His teacher described him as mentally slow, unsociable, and always dreaming. Albert Einstein. Fired from the newspaper because he lacked imagination and had no original ideas. What is he? Cut from the basketball school team. He ran home, hid in the room, and cried. Michael Jordan. But the most inspirational phrase came right at the last page of the book. By like George Custer. It's not the number of times that you fall down. It's the number of times you get back up. Immediately, I felt a surge of energy taking over me, energizing me from head to toe. I felt confidence flowing through my veins, once again renewing my chi and awakening my senses. Wow! I thought to myself, I too can achieve great things. We all have the potential to do great things. Friends, fellow Toastmasters, we all have the potential to achieve anything we desire. Seeing things differently is a gift. Being unique is a charm. And being just you is amazing. People will always tend to see you, judge you, condemn you, criticize you based on what they see. But no matter how they see you, you must know that only you know yourself best. Today, let me urge you, emulate you, and challenge you to believe in yourself, because you have the potential to achieve anything you desire, and because you can do it. When you believe, not good enough, think again. Contest champion.